Amos chapter 8. Thus hath the Lord God showed unto me, behold, a basket of summer fruit. And he said, Amos, what seest thou? Love how God is. God knows what he wants you to answer. Adam, what did you? What'd you do? God knew what he did. And I said, a basket of summer fruit. Then said the Lord unto me, the end is come upon my people of Israel. So what's going to happen? The end. As it happened, Israel went into captivity. So a person that rejects Jesus Christ as their Savior, the Bible says he will have damnation and condemnation and end up in the lake of fire which burns forever. What will happen to them? Exactly what the Bible says. You know, when Saul was talking to, when Samuel was talking to Saul, did you see how pinpoint he put the prophecy to Saul? They were going to have certain amount of loaves of bread. They were going to give you a certain amount of loaves of bread. He's going to have a certain amount of kids, and blah, and on, and on. You're going to meet this certain amount of prophets. God is 100% prophecy. If he's 99.9%, he's not God. The 100% prophecy that you have in the Bible, in God, Jehovah, the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the Word, that is your faith. God said it. Well, how do you know God really said it? Faith. Do you really believe what that Bible says? And do you really believe if you put a quarter in a machine and pull its arm down, you're going to get three cherries? You know, I wonder how many people put their quarter in one of those machines and pulled down the lever, got the three cherries, and nothing came out. You see, what are you trying to say? Each and every single time God says, and it will come to pass. Now, if everything to 2016 that God's already prophesied has come to be, Israel is in captivity. Judah was taken by the Babylonian army. They were taken and the land was destroyed. Ezra brought them back by the king, Cyrus. If that's all come to pass, if that's all comes to true, if 48 prophecies about the Lord Jesus Christ has been fulfilled by his first coming to the empty tomb. The Bible speaks about a lot more prophecies, more than 48, that are yet to come. As much as we find in Amos chapter 8 that Israel does have an end, the northern tribes, you better be sure when we read that the end of tribulation is going to be dark, no sun, no moon, no star. Guess what's going to happen? You better believe when the Bible says there's going to be seven vials, seven trumpets, three woes, seven, I forgot one in there, seals. Guess what you better believe? You better believe when the Bible says when the trumpet of God blows, those that are dead in Christ are going to rise first, and those that are alive, what do you think is going to happen? He's not going to take the lost people. He's going to take those that are saved. That is our blessed hope, Titus 13. That is what we put our faith upon. When God said it, this is what God has said. I wish they mark all Bibles. The Word of Christ in red and the Word of God in blue. To realize God said, Israel, you're coming to an end, and I am stressing. That's exactly what happens. I will not again pass by them anymore. You say, well, doesn't he bring back the raiment? Isn't there the 144,000? He's talking about these Jews right here and now, these Israelites. these ones that have sinned. He's already told you, listen, if the son sins, they're not going after the father. The father sins, you're not going after the child. He's dealing with these Jews present. He's done with them. They're done. They have an end. The songs of the temple. We've already talked about the temple and the chapel. In the church service. Shall be howling in the day, in that day. So from singing to howling, screaming, acting like an animal, saith the Lord God. So guess what's going to happen? What happened when Israel went into captivity? They were singing in the temple, having a good old time, and then they turned it into howling. Why? There shall be many dead bodies in every place. Wasn't that the cry of Egypt that night when the death angel came through? There was not a house, but there wasn't a dead body. It said among the rich and among the poorest, and even the animals, they shall cast them forth with silence. And we read that not last night, but chapter 6. Where the one dies in his house and the uncle buries him. Shh, don't say anything. Don't mention God. Why? He's done with you. So do you still want to be under the law? Didn't we read today that said God was with Saul? Well, what happened with Saul? He ended up dead in hell. You know, if I went trick-or-treating and go visit a witch and a psychic and whatever, however the psychic tells all that, if I read the newspaper every day for my horoscope and stuff like that, I'm a saved child of God and I can't lose that salvation. God said because Saul went and saw that witch, I'm done with him. Now, there's some Old Testament things I like to claim. But I can't nitpick. I can't put my 25-cent quarter into the bubblegum prayer machine and get the bubblegum I want. And sometimes I've had in life like, oh man, I put the quarter in and I turned the dial and I didn't get nothing. And I preached that over and over in prisons. Death. God said it's going to happen, and it did. We're reading before it happened. Hear this, O ye that swallow up the needy. That's an interesting statement. You devour those people that have need. Overtax them. Overburden them. You don't pay them enough. You keep them needy. You know that's a violation of the law too? To the Jew. Even to make the poor of the land to fail. They can't get anywhere. God is, or Jehovah is acknowledging this as the sin why Israel's done with. They are not helping their fellow brethren, the Jews. They're making them worse off. Saying, when will the new moon be gone? That's the first of the month. That we may sell corn. So something about the new moon and selling. I guarantee when they're keeping them needing, keep them filled. They probably had diverse weights. That we may sell corn, and the Sabbath, that we may set forth wheat, making the ephah small. See, they're changing. You know, instead of a metal little disc to weigh it out, it looks metal, it looks like the weight, but it's really styrofoam. or cardboard. And the shekel grate. And falsifying the balance by deceit, and that is against the law of God. The shekel grate is the benefit to the rich people. The ephod small is to the disadvantage of the needy of all. So what we're going to do is, we're not going to pay you full price for your crops, and then when we charge you for a piece of meat, we're going to charge you for the bone that's in it too. Now, do you eat the bone? Now, if you got a dog at home, something like that, all right, then charge for the bone. Why doesn't meat departments in stores and all that cut off the meat from the bone rather than weigh it? That we may buy the poor for silver. Chapter 2, verse 6. Wasn't there a thing in the law that says you weren't supposed to buy a fellow Jew? You weren't supposed to sell? You see how they're breaking the law? This is northern Israel. They don't even go to the temple in Jerusalem. They've got their own religious service. They've got their own gods. They got their own priests. They got 450 priests of Baal. Under, I can't even think of her name now. Jezebel. But you see, even though they got their own religion, you see how God's tying them to His word, His law that they're supposed to believe. You know what? God is going to attack Baptists, I'll put them first, Catholics, Mormons, Jehovah Witnesses, Hindus, and any other religion, atheists, just as much going to attack them by what the Bible says than what they do. I don't believe the Bible. God doesn't care. He's still going to bring you to the thing. These Jews here in Israel didn't believe the law. They didn't believe. They didn't follow it. They didn't care to. Rehoboam. Can't remember now. When the nation split, there was Solomon's son. Rehoboam. And then the nation split. And the king of Israel built a wall so they wouldn't go down. But God says, what he's saying right here is, this is what the law says. You're under it. I don't care you don't believe it. I don't care you follow it. You're under it. So, I don't care you believe Jesus. I don't care you believe he's a prophet. I don't care you believe he's just a teacher. I don't care if you don't believe that he wasn't even who he was. Bible says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. You don't believe in Jesus Christ, you won't be saved. I didn't believe that. God says, I don't care. Now picture for a moment a lost person standing before God at the final judgment. Picture God looking at him saying, I don't care. Now a mom and dad, when they tell a child, I don't care, a child can sometimes maybe make the parent do care and give in. You know, but not God. When God told that Jew, you're supposed to follow the law, you follow the law. When God tells the church age people that are in the church, and I mean everybody that's in the church, the Jew and the Gentile, this is what you need to be. This is what must be done. He must be born again. And if you don't do it, you're going to be charged. Now let's read on. That we may buy the poor for silver and the needy for a pair of shoes. That's a low price. Let's bring the Bible up to modern thing. You go to Walmart, you need a pair of shoes, you go in there, you try them, you find out a pair you like, right? You go up to the cash register, take your child and put them in the cash register. Here, take my child for the pair of shoes. Oh! That's what they were doing. You go to the bank, you bring a poor man. Here's a poor man. And he gives you silver. They're selling Jews. Yay! And sell the refuse of the wheat. Now what's that? That's the chaff. That's the no good stuff. That's the stuff. they are breaking the wheat apart on the threshing floors, and they're collecting the junk, and they're selling it. Let's see. What would be a good word for that today? Starts with an F and ends with an S. Fillers? There was a company who just got caught putting wood dust in a certain graded product and got caught. That's exactly what's going on here. No profit of ethics of measures and weight. The Lord has sworn by the excellency of Jacob. I don't know what that means. But he is sworn by their father, Jacob, of who they are as a tribe. It's Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, the 12 tribes. Jacob is the foundation of the tribes, the 12 individual groups that for now are going to be forever, you know, Dan, Judah, Isaac, Jacob. Surely I will never forget any of their works. That sounds good, doesn't it? What are the works? You've been stiffing everybody. You've been buying them off. You've been making them work. Those are the works that we just read, verses 4 through 6. I like to have those works under your belt. See, I'm a good person. I keep the commandments. Okay? How many hours have you spent at the water cooler fooling around at work? Well, no, we don't count that. How many times have you looked at a woman with a bikini? Hey, hey, hey. No. We're looking at good works, aren't we? Is it a good works? Didn't I walk old ladies across the street? Didn't I give to this organization? Didn't I donate all my old clothes to this company? And God said, what about your sins? For every good thing you do, you probably do two or three sins. How can you pay? How can these people, let's put these people here, how can they pay? They have to go to the people and humbly say, I'm going to use a bad word, I shortchanged you. And the law says you have to make restitution plus 5% more. Now, who's going to do that that's in pride and arrogancy and not going to follow God? Yeah, you went in the prayer closet and prayed to that priest. Okay? What about all those images that you worshipped? What about being a cannibal and how many times you ate Jesus? Definitely against the Bible, both testaments. See, when you're dealing with somebody, oh, I'm a good person. Yeah, but aren't you also a bad person? You can't be all good. You've never wanted to seek revenge from your boss, landlord, or somebody that sold you a bad product. Never. That's just as bad as the good works. Why'd you do the good works? So look what he says here. Shall not the land tremble for this? Now this is the land of Palestine. Even though we're talking about North Israel, that's still the land that was given to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and 12 tribes. The land is utterly shocked and their disobedience. And God passing judgment upon them, no rain, the locusts, the cankerworms, and whatever Job said. The land is not producing the milk and honey. And everyone mourn that dwell therein. Why? There's death. They're being mistreated. They're not getting a big enough paycheck. But someone else is. And it shall rise up wholly as a flood. Destruction. It shall be cast out and drowned. As by the flood of Egypt. Death. Damage. it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord God, that I will cause the sun to go down at noon, and I will darken the earth in the clear day. Well, that's the end of tribulation passage right there. So when the sun stops shining, is a nice clear day. And they want the day of darkness. Didn't we read that? Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord, is not darkness. I will turn your feast into mourning. Now, these are not the feasts prescribed in the book of Moses, because they're not obeying Moses. They've got their own religious holidays. Easter, Lent, Mardi Gras, 4th of July, this guy's birthday, that guy's birthday. Talking to the nation of Israel, they've got their own religion. Now they've got their own feast. And all your songs into lamentation. They got their own songs too. And boy, have they crept into the church. And we already read that the singing is going to turn into howling. It's also going to turn into lamentations. And I will bring up sackcloth upon your loins. This picture's flesh. Yuckiness. And baldness upon every head. Loss of hair. You know, there is a thing when you shave your head, and many of the gods worship, it was for the dead. They would shave their head. But who knows anything like that? Not saying everybody does it because they're dead, but you ought to know why you're doing something. Because you think God's going to hold you. Oh, you didn't know. Oh, poor baby. I'm sorry. Sorry. I can't give you no hallway passes. God will hold you accountable because he tells you, study to show thyself approved unto God. Workman that needs not to be shamed. Rightly divine word of truth. Well, he's not saved. You can be saved. Oh, he should have known. Here's a Bible. Shut up with your excuses. There is no excuse with God and before God. Talking to the wrong person, you want an excuse. I won't have excuses either. I will be accountable to my sins that are not under the blood. And I will make it as the mourning of an only son. The mourning of an only son. Death. Despair. And the end, that's the second time, verse 8, chapter 8, thereof as a bitter day. Want you to desire the day of the Lord as the day of darkness. We're talking about the second advent. It's also when Israel went into captivity. You say, well, how could it have gone dark? And I don't know how the Lord did it, but that's what the Bible says. A man told God, please, Lord, keep the sun up all day so we fight this battle. And didn't God do it? A man told God, we'll make the sundial go back 10 degrees. God did it. Is anything too hard for the Lord? Absolutely nothing. Can God make a rock that's too heavy? Yeah, throw on your dippy head. And it'd be ain't too hard, ain't too rock too big that God's thrown in your head you can't get out under? Idiot. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land. You say, well, he's already sending a famine. Not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord. And Jesus said, I am the bread. And I am the water of life. There's coming a time in the Jewish history that you're not going to have no bread and no water. When is that time? Right now. Jesus said, I am the bread of life and I'm the water of life. Now, When was this wanted in the Bible? You better be very careful what you open up your big mouth. Because let's go back to Amos chapter 7, verse 11. For thus says Amos, Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel shall surely be led away captive out of his own land. Also Amaziah said to Amos, O thou seer, go, flee thee unto a land of Judah, and there eat bread, and prophesy there. But prophesy not again any more in Bethel, for it is the king's chapel, it is the king's court, and we base this whole thing on the word of God. So God said, okay, Amaziah, priest of the nation, under the king, you don't want to hear my preaching? You're not going to get no preaching. So the 144,000 that run in the tribulation are not Jehovah Witnesses. And would it be funny with the devil, how much he puts things there? Would it be funny around, they're just running around with Hebrew Bibles? Wouldn't it be great, the only Bibles in the tribulation period would be Hebrew? That's going to do a lot of good for the Gentiles who don't know no Hebrew. Now I'm just throwing that in there. But they did not want the word of God. So God said, okay, fine, I'm going to give you a famine of it. Those bread and bread. So you better be careful when somebody, if you're lost, you better be careful when somebody comes in your life and tell you about Jesus. I don't want to hear that no more. You better be very careful. Because God just answered that prayer in 14, 15 verses. All right, you don't want to hear it? I won't give it to you. For thirst of water, but the hearing of the words of the Lord and bread. Again, Jesus Christ. Type of bread, type of water. You never see the Catholic Church offering water but baptism. Here, sprinkle. They shall wander from sea to sea. Mediterranean to the Dead Sea, Sea of Galilee. And from the north even to the east. That's kind of weird because you would be north to south. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of God, or the Lord, excuse me, and shall not find it. In that day shall the fair virgins and young men faint for thirst. Now that's not water. We've already told, not of bread and not of water. There's going to be a time in history they're going to drop in the streets because of the lack of word. So you better get your diet of the Bible. They shall swear by the sin of Samaria, the calves, and say, thy God, O Dan, liveth, and the manor of Beersheba liveth. That's the calves. Even they shall fall and never rise up again. These calves are going to backslide. They're not getting up out of the hole. They got their own worship. Aren't calves and cows called beasts in the Bible? Where's that reference to in the Bible? 666. So we see, you got to watch your step. God is serious. And God is 100%.